Alright, let's get this rolling here. Once everything starts transmitting over to YouTube, I'll explain. Alright, come on. Unless there's a hell of a delay again, which there usually is. But once I see it pop up on there. Jeez, must be on a hell of a lag tonight. I don't know what OBS is right now. Why are you not going live? What is wrong with you? YouTube, are you broken? Are you a broken YouTube? Yeah. Head delay none. I wonder if it's because it started and it stopped. It says starting. YouTube, are you broken? Oh yeah, because it's saying elapsed time. There we go, we got it working this time. Alright, what we're going to see in this one is... I better not put the damn... There we go, now we're on that. Hey, you guys can see my cursor finally. Alright, this is going to be a little taste of pretty much what... we're going to be doing here in the future with Carlile. This is the heavy haul division. So what we're going to do is we're going to get us a load number one, which requires us to go to the freight market. As you can see, this is our T800. Well, I'll show you a better look in a minute here. We are currently in Fresno. So what we're going to do is we're going to look for a load that doesn't go ridiculously far. Alright, we're going to take a ridiculously short load just so we can... this looks pretty good, 57,000 pounds. So yeah, we'll go from Fresno to Los Angeles. And that's going to probably be right here in the same yard. Now it's not, so we're going to roll out and go to wherever it's at. Anytime we get the green light, oh yep, we get that Prius in the light there. My cell just has a big ass loader. I don't know. Clouds bolted on that happened. That's still weird. Oh, we're not picking it up. But still, why the hell did it? I guess maybe they. Maybe Voltazon stands for Volvo, who the fuck knows. Let's roll up in here, let's confirm our load first, and then once I hook up to it, there's our Volvo EW230C, whatever the hell that is. We'll find out in a minute. There it is right there. Well, it's two, so let's see what we got. We've got a track hoe, but it's not a track hoe. It actually has wheels, so it's a wheel hoe. So once I hook up this and get out, I'll explain. Into it, get our beacons and strobes going. See if we can get out of here without damaging our car grinding. Or our transmissions. Basically, what we have here is our official T800, and it is equipped with a Cummins ISX 600 series, so 600 horsepower. We've got our standard wide load with a push bar in case you're doing push trucking. Also has a headache rack and our drop down axle. Going down for the absolutely ridiculous hauls. We've got our drop down, and as a heavy haul driver, once we have the division open, you will be pulling nothing but the biggest and the most badass cargoes out there with this, the Beast. It's not the fastest truck, but speed is not how you handle heavy loads. So basically it's a 38 inch micro sleeper, which you don't need a big sleeper for a heavy haul. We've got our guide poles, aka rookie sticks. We've got our beacon, all of them are standard. I think it's 300 gallon tank, stretch frame, and yeah, we're pretty much going to start trucking with it. Now I did move the views and stuff back so I could see easier. I cannot see my mirror before. Get out of here without tearing anything up. I love the sound of the compass. Really? A car drills me right out of the gate. Smart move, jackpot. Move, damn it. Are you gonna fucking move, car, or are you just gonna sit there? Back ass up more. Yeah, now drive off, you jerk. That's hit and run. Felony hit and run. Oh, you shut the back. Alright, take two. Hopefully no dumbass inside that one. Pull out the other lane. I have decided to put on my huge 2-foot ape hanger sister. Just makes shipping easier. So much easier than using a small little hop on the G27. Brake on, always stays on. No further comment. I'm just glad nobody else can hear your ass except for me. No, you would ruin the image of the company. I know how you drive. Or, more like I know how you don't know how to drive. Isn't heavy enough that I think that the tag axle should be down. It's only 37,000 pounds. It's a long trailer. Alright, we got 200 something miles to go to get to lights, no nothing. more so than ever, I have to be careful around AI traffic. Which, once we get on the long hauls of doing it, it'll be a lot easier. Because, obviously, you've seen the traffic isn't as bad on the, once you get out of California, the traffic isn't so bad. So we're basically just going to do a couple runs here, see if I can get a good long haul with something really freaking heavy. So you guys can really see what Carlile is all about as we pass one of our reefer trailers there. It'd probably be better to drive predominantly at night, but there's no fun in waiting at night for night time to come, so. It looks like it's gonna rain too. Like Let's see, where do we need it? And they want it to run back, don't they? Nope, they want it right there. Perfect. So this bad boy in reverse here and see if we need one shot. Probably gonna tell me that I fucked up. Yep. Alright, so level 17. I'm still working on eco driving because really, really need that when doing these long runs. What the hell are you saying? You kept having it where your fucking truck was so loud I couldn't hear a goddamn thing. Well, yeah. I don't hear your freaking truck. You need to stick to freight. Let's see, we are in Los Angeles. Do we have any big ass crazy lids? There's a 66,000 pound going to Columbus. Here's a big son of a bitch here, 74,000 pounds going to Columbus. Do we have anything bigger? 66,000 pounds going to San Rafael. We want to get out of the state of California, though. So we're going to take this huge, whatever this is, going to Columbus for $51,000. Why is that so good? Your guess is as good as mine. I guess they sold it good enough. Fucking trucks, I swear to God, you son of a bitch. Well, everything was clear in this. Really? Now a camper wants to do it too? I swear to God, the next car, I'm just gonna ram off the fucking road. The only thing I hate about single player, so you, the AI is non-existent in multi. And this motherfucker just hooks a right turn automatically. Trailer bit. I'm pulling in to get gas before I leave. God, it's expensive out here on the West Coast. Stop! See, now all my air brake, all my air brake sounds are working right. For hell, it isn't the worst place to drive. Wait, no. Was it Washington where I kept getting hit? Yeah, Washington is the worst place ever to drive. Freaking down, the worst place to drive. Hell, I figured Boston was gonna be bad, but wouldn't shit on Washington, but those guys really didn't know that guy. Boston was awesome. Yeah. That's when I ran out of gas on. Like a half a block from the gas station. Yeah, that one was freaking cool. Yeah, no, right? They change colors up. Yep. I don't know if it's a glitch. I can't see them because I got the mirrors too. I can't see the tops of mine because I moved my, I moved the view back and up because it's too freaking low for me. F4. Keep hitting it until it goes to the seat adjustment. Hey, look, Santa Monica lights. Damn, there we go. Center of the window is right in the way. Bitch, getting us out of here. Oh, I see my load already and it's freaking huge. Nah, this is gonna be fun. Oh, this is gonna be a load of fun. The recruitment center there. Went just far enough to discover it. So our load is sitting right in here. Trigger up. Get this thing out of here in one piece. Make sure I clear everything. pitchers on this road, so we can use full advantage of swinging extra wide for that. Oh, and we're going to drop our axle down too, so we have all three on the ground. Gear. We definitely don't need low hold. Oh yeah. This bitch is heavy. Definitely a third gear, not first gear. And we are definitely going to wait for the green light on this because I need every inch of road. Double gear right here. Fifth, seventh, blah, blah, blah. Operation while my W900 sits quiet in the headquarters at Elko. Around the world. sometimes feel like it's not dropping enough. Or it's dropping too much. I'd be glad to get the hell on the interstate. The red light's kicking my ass right now. Even though you can turn right on red here, I'm going to wait till green. And I'm definitely going to let that... Well, yeah, go ahead. Go, dude. That doesn't mean you too, car. Jeez. Really? That'll be red. Round that one a bit. Alright, looks like only a couple more, hopefully a couple more red lights and we're the hell out of Los Angeles. As long as it's ever taken me to get the hell out of the city. Some of us ain't got all day. I got 2,300 miles to drive. Are you ever gonna go there, Mr. Kenworth? I'm kind of blocking traffic here, so you need to get some ass in gear. What the fuck are you doing? Really? Thank you so much, you fucking piece of shit in a Volvo. I think this is what truckers have to deal with on a daily basis, and the reason why they're pissed off a lot of times. doubled or half off. Speed limit's 55 knots, whatever you feel like. I think it'd be cool to just fly off the interstate like that. Either way to get killed, dude. And they've got me snaking through freaking California on these twisty ass back roads. Yep. Well, this is the perfect. Actually, I can't ask for anything better. This is the perfect way. How you should handle yourself, especially when you have an oversized load and you're on a two-lane road. It's not long though, it's just a connector to I-40. But still. You hit one? I went back up. Yeah, don't do that. God. fifth gear, dude. Fifth gear. And a pissed off line of traffic behind me. Tough shit. They're not hauling a 77,000 pound oversized two. The truck will get up and go once it's off the hill. Now the shitty part is it's gonna be making this 90-degree off ramp or on ramp. Don't say that because that's the next thing that'll happen here. I got nothing but a lot of traffic, so I can arc my corner coming out. Well, that's because it's got double low in it. Traffic is actually being nice. They're letting me out of the way. Yeah, for once. I'm actually in double gear here. And we're on I-40. We will be on I-40 for a long ass time. Pass on the hammer lane here. Normally I It looked like it from the side, but there's that other one that looks just like our trailers. I got 2023. Yeah, but you're not pulling 70,000 pounds. Oh, I keep playing the downshift game here. As soon as I get it up in final gear, it's like always up to downshift. Ew, no. No. If anything, 7-Up. Today. Wow. With the cruise control, it automatically trips the jank if you're going over. W9 doesn't do that. It just has that little red motor brake that comes on. No place worse than DC. I haven't been there. I wanted to go. Why? It's not gonna be like real New York City. These are all small prefabs. Slides out. Well, diesel's only $2 a gallon out here versus almost $3. Well, since we've gone this far, let's take a pre-trip, or not a pre-trip, but a maintenance. Oh shit, we gotta wait for fuel. Yeah, blow your horn at me, asshole. I'll get out of your way in a minute. I gotta do something here. Out, people. God, road rage much? God damn. There, now you can drive around me. Yeah, doing an inspection of my truck. Holy shit. Yeah, this is. And that damn truck just drove in and straight out. Yes, you still needed gas. Yeah, you know, it's good. Driving by. That's gonna take friggin' forever. It's about 1500 to go. And surprise, surprise, another hill. Having a full radius fender for the tag like actual like having a half bender or a quarter bender. That was Carlile, right? And then another one. Like having a quarter radius for the tag axle and then having a half bender in paint for chrome instead of the stupid full radius ones. That shit don't belong on an American truck. Oh, okay, I was just passing one bulldozer and now I gotta pass another one. At least my foot's getting a break because it's on a cruise. I'm probably pissing a lot of people off staying in the hammer lane too, but I don't care. Airport. 5 miles as close as I would go. Well, the way he had it drawn up, it was garbage. Yes, that's what it was. It was living good. Then you had 5 miles. Then you had the roller coaster. And then you had the cutoff of the Bettles Trail. And then there was the chandelier. Airport, or was that called something else? Because there was an airport there. Because I know there was Chandelier Station. That was just before you got to Attigan. And then everything after Chandelier Station, there was Chandelier, or no, it was the Alyeska pump station after Attigan. Then you had was the truck stop though, up by where was that at? That was actually a town too. Coldfoot. Yep, you had the truck, the only service center on the entire freaking highway between Fairbanks. Welcome to St. Louis. Oh, okay, I see what it is. It's funny because I should still be on I-40. Last time I checked, St. Louis had been down. 30 somebody that can make a like a pro mod quality map, I'd pay them to do it. Yes, you did. Remember the logging map? Wasn't the best map, but you did the map. Triple X did map. Well, no, Triple X kind of like hosted all of Phantom's mods. If Hawksby was still around, Hawksby, is he still going by that name? Doing a free one, maybe he would put that one on hold if we pay him to do one for us. But that one doesn't get released to the public. Actually, you know what? I don't care if it gets released to the public. But the credit, we have to be included in the credit. be out by November or January. He can't do that and stay present. Two Carlile trucks back to back. That's because my post is right. Well, they are. What the fuck? Thank you so much, you jackass, for kicking me out. Dumbass. I got a bright, wet-ass screen in my face. Turn her off. I want to see it. get a truck stop. Feels like the longest trip ever. cops. Whoa, what's going on here? Big brake check. Damn, dude, you're gonna get showed up by a heavy haul truck? What are we coming up on? Obviously, it's a town I've been to before. Thinking that lane was going to stay there for the truck stop. I don't need that info up anymore then. See how low we actually were. I'm gonna guess I'm back up, it's 208. Do a quick visual inspection here. Whoops. Escape and the one are too close to each other. Thank you. lights on. My beacons. Can't be worse than what I had to drag it out of. It took me almost 20 minutes just to get out of LA with it. And that's 20 minutes real time. I shoulder likes to suck you over. Hey, there's that tanker that walked off and dusted me at the truck stop. Time to repay him Carlile style. He gonna get sacked. Maybe. Columbus and Pittsburgh. Knowing my luck, I'll go out and try to pass them, and my exit will be coming up, and we're going to have to play who's going to hit the brakes first. And I don't like the rate that I'm closing on. Buddy, in your little day cab. Don't feel bad, mine's pretty much a day cab. Like a few inches for a sleeper. If I lay sideways in it, I can sleep. Once I see those on the back, I know I'm clear. I keep thinking this trailer's a hell of a lot longer than it. Slightly more powerful engine to stick in this truck than a 600 or 604. Like maybe a 750 or 800. Welcome to Ohio. Well, we closed it down to 132 miles now. Sun should be coming up over our eyes here shortly. If we are traveling through east, that is. It'd be nice to get back in my W900. Less than 100 out. Headed true east because become the challenging part. Two most trying times are leaving your origin city and arriving at your destination city. Sell goods too. Come on. on the money spot right there. Alright, so let's detach our load. See what we get paid for this one. 51 grand, I'll take that. Awesome. Well, that right there basically is going to be the average everyday occurrence for a heavy haul driver. Low and slow. Pain in the ass, but get stuff there dedicated, then that's how it goes. We don't need that. Anyways, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And don't forget, I left the links down the bottom. If you're looking for an awesome company to drive for, you're more than welcome to check us out.